All my coordination went out the window.
Do you still have any food rules? Prefer to you when you were thinner? Digestion issues? Do you another fun cheat day video?
What is going on, guys? Welcome to the video. So I'm actually super excited about this video. I did ask you guys on both Instagram and YouTube community to submit some questions, and I was looking for some juicy questions. I have a lot of ones that I want to get through, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So the first question is one that was super popular. A lot of people were really curious if I missed being shredded. Like, did I miss my old skinny body? Do you sometimes wish you could go back to being shredded? And the short answer to that is no. I think that there were a lot more negatives to being really shredded than there were positives. And I kind of have to go, to answer this question properly, I kind of have to go back into the mindset of when I was really shredded right before I went all in. So the mindset that I had at that time was that, like, I really wanted to look really fit because I thought that's what the fitness community kind of wanted out of me. Because, like, I never really felt fit enough. So I always thought that I needed to be more in shape. So I felt like this overwhelming pressure that I needed to, like, go on a cut. I needed to be more fit. I was afraid that if I didn't maintain that level of leanness,
so your body fat's gonna pop up here,
or that level of fitness, that I would no longer be respected in the fitness industry. I have now realized is a bunch of bullshit, and it put me down a rabbit hole of being stuck feeling like I needed to be lean all the time. I don't want to go back there because when I was there, I didn't like how sunken in my face looked, and I didn't like that my boobs would basically, like, eviscerate, and I felt like I was losing a lot of muscle being that lean. So there was a lot more negatives than the positives of, like, the credibility I gained, like looking really skinny in my face. I felt like it aged me a lot and it made me look a lot older, and now somebody who is 30 years old, I feel like an old woman. I don't want to look any older than I already do now. So having, you know, like, a healthier amount of body fat on my body livens up my face a lot, gives me a curvy, more feminine physique, in my opinion.
I look okay?
You look great.
That's what I like on me. I'm not saying that I have anything against certain bodies. I don't think that there's anything wrong with any body type, but on me personally, I didn't love the way that it looked on me. I'm so happy that I don't ever feel like I need to appease that part of the internet anymore, because I'm done being shredded, and I don't miss it. I'm gonna be honest, I don't miss it. Okay, so the next question is, would you ever do another fun cheat day video even while going all in? This question really excited me because I was actually planning on doing and attempting my first cheat day video.
Because today I am doing a cheat day.
Like, I was going to, now that I had, you know, no longer have extreme hunger, I was gonna do a video where I attempt to eat like an old cheat day, my first cheat day.
Last time I felt satisfied is when I did a 10K challenge, so my life was a struggle.
And I had that video planned for March of this year, and it was right before everything happened with the lockdown and the quarantine. You guys will have to let me know if you guys would still be interested in seeing that video, because I think it would be a really fun and eye-opening video to make, and it would just be for fun. It wouldn't be for trying to overeat or anything like that. I think it would be a great video to demonstrate, like, how much my appetite has decreased and how much more in tune I am with my, like, hunger and satiety signals. So kind of like the first video option I was thinking about was attempting to do an old cheat day. And then the second option would be, like, not trying to attempt any of my previous cheat days, but just to have a fun and lighthearted cheat day as somebody who is in the position they're in right now. So either one would be kind of fun and would be really interesting and insightful, I think, to me, to see how much my appetite has changed. So let me know down below. Okay, so this is a two-part question, and I think this is a really, really good question. So the first part is, do you ever feel like you need to binge, like really eat a lot, just like your body is still testing you? If yes, when did it stop? And then the second part of the question is, did you feel psychological hunger? like was not hungry in the stomach, but your brain wanted you to eat. If yes, when did it stop? Do I ever really feel like I need to binge? And I'm assuming she means right now because she's wondering if my body's like still testing me. That is definitely a no. So more than anything right now, I'm struggling with the opposite problem. I feel like my appetite is really low. So I don't personally think my body is still trying to test me. I think that my body has a very clear understanding of its current appetite, and I don't really eat beyond that right now. And I usually eat 3 rolls. Sometimes I don't always finish all 3. And of course, like I am human, there are definitely days where I'm hungrier than other days. Like usually a day where my appetite's pretty low, it's usually followed by a day that my appetite is so much higher. And it also depends on like how much I trained that day. Like if I had like a really hard leg day, sometimes that will make me feel really hungry and things like that. So my appetite does fluctuate from day to day, but I never really feel like I need to binge or ever really feel like I need to eat a lot. That is something that I no longer experience. I wanna kind of like put into perspective of the way that I was before I went all in. I had extreme hunger, but I was like extremely disciplined, and I guess like that would be the word I would use. I was really disciplined, and I actually didn't binge before I went all in. That was not something that I personally struggled with. What I struggled with my extreme appetite was that like I would eat to like 60% full, and then I would stop because I was so disciplined. Like I'd be like, okay, Stephanie, that's enough calories. You had like 1800 calories for the day. Like that's enough. I know you're still hungry, but stop there. And I would, even though I was still hungry because I had such a crazy appetite. And that was what I practiced prior to going all in. And that was what drove me nuts. Like I was going insane, constantly feeling like I wanted to eat more, but I wouldn't. Once I went all in, all bets were off. Floodgates literally just opened, and I was allowing myself to eat as much as I felt like I needed to feel satiated.
Okay, so this is what I had for breakfast. I had 2 large bananas, I had 2 packets of oatmeal, I had an apple, and then I had 4 sweet potatoes, and I had 2 scoops of protein. Nice. Is that normal?
So this goes into the second part of the question, is if I ever felt psychological hunger. And that's something that I like to call like mental hunger. In my opinion, I've experienced both physical hunger and mental hunger. And the mental hunger was definitely at its peak when I first went all in.
This is just a snack. I had breakfast already.
Gotcha.
Like I said, all bets were off. Floodgates open, hunger was rampant. I would eat and eat and eat probably like every single hour in my first and second month.
And I was probably still hungry after that. I was, but I had to stop because I needed to do some work, or else I'll just keep eating.
I was super hungry, and I would just allow myself to eat. So much so that I felt like I had like a perma food baby. Like I was just like, my skin would feel like it was stretching. My physical fullness was definitely there, but my mental fullness wasn't satisfied. Like I would feel like so big and bloated, and my stomach would feel like it's gonna pop, and I would still be like, man, I could go for some ice cream though. My mental hunger was never satisfied. Even in those times though, to be honest with you, I wouldn't ever constitute the way that I ate as a binge, because I would eat like a meal, then I would eat a little bit more and be like, okay, I could eat a little bit more. I wouldn't completely lose control. I was actually very mindful of what I was doing and kind of mentally cataloging how I was feeling and what I was doing for the sake of like documentation. And I would write in my journal how I was feeling and how I was doing. So I was definitely well aware of what was going on. I don't think I ever like lost control. And that usually characterizes a traditional binge. In the third month, that kind of went away. Like I didn't experience that as often. Like I would feel physically full and then I would stop.
100% satisfied.
100%.
Whoa.
That is what Bali has done to me.
Because my mental hunger really wasn't as prominent anymore. I think it was like 3 months all in, and I have like a video where I'm actually super shocked.
But I also feel like I'm not nearly as hungry anymore. I'm gonna say that again for the people in the back.
And being more in tune with my internal like hunger signals, like when those started to kick in is when mental hunger started to abate. Okay guys, it's not really a juicy question, but it makes me feel some type of way. Why do you think so many people, specifically men weirdly, had such a bad reaction to your all-in journey? I have been pondering this question for the last year and a half. So if any of you guys know why, I would love to know in the comments down below, because I personally don't really know why. Jeff and I have gone through so many different possibilities as to why we think it is. And I think the most likely candidate of all of them is that men do not think women know anything about nutrition.
There could be a double standard. So like if I post a squat video and there's a bit of butt wink, no one will bat an eye, at least not in my audience. But if I post a video of you squatting and there's a bit of butt wink, everyone is gonna try to fix it for you. It could be that thing where some men just wanna, like they almost wanna help women, but when it's not really welcome in a way.
So their immediate reaction to anyone trying to say anything about diet or nutrition is immediately wrong. Like it is their duty to correct whoever's wrong. And most of those people who thought I was wrong were men because they just didn't understand it. Like I had all of like the scientific community on my side, dietitian and nutrition experts, all of them were on my side. Like they were like, yes, this is what the literature shows happens. This is how a body reacts to eating enough food to supply like biological processes, enough sustenance to continue when you halt them and your menstrual cycle and all of these things need to kick back on. So you need a lot of food and all of that was backing me. But it seemed like it was mostly a female community that was backing me. It was kind of offensive because I had done so much research and I had read so much literature. I felt like I was pretty confident. I was really familiar with starvation studies, overfeeding studies. I was also really familiar with like set weight regulation theories that scientists have. I wasn't just speaking out of my ass and I didn't jump into this all-in extreme journey without at least reading some science to back this up. I do not know. So if you want to correct me, I would love it if you were to do so in the comments because I would like to know. And one more thing about this is that I never made my all-in journey prescriptive ever. I never told anybody that you should do this. I was very clear in saying that, hey, I'm going to try this thing out. Seemed like I was a good candidate. I'm going to do this. And I wanna share this journey with you. I just had to say that because it's like a vent session. I needed to vent that out. Okay, next question. How do you deal with the fact that even though you are healthier and happier now, a lot of the fitness industry slash society, etc., preferred you when you were thinner? So this is something that I've kind of had to deviate from to have like such a myopic view of the fitness industry because I've come to learn that the fitness industry is actually a lot broader than I was originally aware of. Like I always kind of fell into the niche of fitness of like people who kind of stayed really, really shredded year round. That is just one facet of the fitness industry. Would I say that that fitness industry no longer prefers me? They probably prefer me thinner, which would constitute their perception of what fit is. Kind of feel like I left that behind and I've joined like a different community, a more body acceptance community. People here in this community are so much more charitable with me when it comes to my body and accepting me at any weight. So I just realized that I didn't touch on like the societal pressure. She did mention both fitness industry and society. In my opinion, I don't really feel like society rewards ultra skinny. I feel like society rewards somewhere in like the Goldilocks zone of looking, still looking like not being too lean, but not being too overweight, which is a difficult place to find yourself. It's like you have to be just right for society to accept you. And that just right is difficult to satisfy. And that is why societal pressure is just so hard, especially on women, because women have to be in this like just right zone for society to deem them acceptable or beautiful. And it's a tough place to be. And the easy way to deal with it is just from like overall happiness. And that's what gets me through not feeling like I need to seek acceptance, but just like trying to be happy. And that actually segues really nicely into a DM that I got. So I'm not gonna show her name because she probably messaged me hoping that it would be private, but it's a really good question that I get pretty often. Do you think you would feel the same about your journey and still decided to do it if your set weight landed higher than it is now? I think that's a great question. I think I get a lot of misconceptions from people thinking that I'm so happy now because I've landed somewhere lower than my highest weight. That is absolutely not true. I don't think that my journey was only worth it because I ended up like at this weight and like the weight, it was weight specific and that I am perceived to look good now. And that's the only reason why I feel like my journey was a success, and that is absolutely not true. I could give you the diplomatic answer and say that I'm happy about the success of my journey because I am healthier and happier now, which is true. I'm not weak anymore, which is true. I'm not as tired anymore. That's also true. I'm gonna keep it super real right now because I just have to say this. Like, the real reason I am super happy is not because where I've landed with my set weight. It's because I am not hungry all the time anymore. I am not hungry all the time. Like, you have no idea what it feels like to feel like you literally want to eat your arm off all the time because you are so hungry. You're so hungry to the point where you like look at everyone at the dinner table wishing you could finish all their food on all the plates of people who didn't finish their food because they had normal appetites. Don't always feel like they have to inhale their food like I did, and I would stare at my empty plate and be like, are you gonna eat that? Oh, are you gonna eat that? That is what I didn't want anymore. So I don't even like the weight that I ended up. Yeah, I personally think it's important to have like a healthy body composition. So I always wanted to end up somewhere within like the normal healthy range with my set weight, but I could almost care less about my set weight because I am just happy that I'm not hungry anymore. If you could only understand like how compromising to my life my appetite was and how hungry I was. It was, if you've never experienced anything like it, you probably can't relate, but it is miserable. It is a miserable way to live, to go to bed every single night still hungry, to stop eating every single meal still hungry, wanting to eat more. It was such a life-changing moment when I no longer felt like that. Even if my set weight landed me higher, I would still think my journey was a success. And I think that I actually did feel really satisfied with my whole journey, even when I didn't know that I was gonna continue losing any more weight. So a really good example of this was back in like February, I was coming down in weight and I wasn't sure that I was gonna continue to lose any more. And I was about like 8 to 10 pounds heavier than I am now. And I was happy then. Like, I was like, this is a success. I feel great. I thought that my journey was a success and I was at a higher, what I perceived to be my set weight. Because I didn't know if I was gonna lose any more weight. And I don't ever want people to think that I feel like my journey worked or that I'm successful or that I'm actually happy now because I look good. No, that has nothing to do with it. I feel so good and I'm not hungry. Okay, so the next question, if you had to do it all over again, would you change anything? This is a really good question, and I took a moment to think about this because I'm not actually sure that I would change anything because every single thing that I perceived that I did wrong ended up having like a downstream effect that probably was positive. If I were to have changed that, would I have learned the same lessons? I'm not sure. So the main thing that comes to mind, my first month all in, I was really focused on making sure I was eating mostly whole foods because I was really focused on like, you know, getting in nutrient dense foods, which is totally fine. And I don't think that that was wrong, but I do feel like it kind of prolonged my journey a bit. Like, I feel like it delayed me from getting into like the real meat of the journey by a month because eating a bunch of whole foods, which was pretty hard on my digestion, which I'll get to digestion in the next question. Eating a lot of whole foods didn't scratch the itch that I felt.
Even chocolate and banana.
It like halfway scratched the itch that I felt for certain cravings and certain foods. And if I could change anything, I wouldn't have had that whole foods rule. And having rules was part of the reason that I had extreme hunger to begin with. So I should have like gone into this having as few rules as possible. I think that would be the one thing that I would change. It is like this ill-perceived notion that you'll eat a bunch of junk food and always want more and more and more junk food. That's the opposite of what happened to me. And it's the opposite of what has happened to everyone that I know that has done this. You don't continue wanting to eat a bunch of junk food. After you get it out of your system, you don't want it anymore. Trust me. I have gone through ebbs and flows of like wanting a lot of sweet food and then a lot of savory food.
That's so good.
Yeah, it looks really good. I expected it to be amazing.
That's lit.
And then once I eat all that savory food, I end up eating like a mostly whole foods diet in the end. But it taught me like a really valuable lesson. Like, I do feel like maybe it was mentally a better approach for me because it wasn't so extreme. So I do think that there was some benefits to it. So I don't know. I don't know if it would have been better either way, but that would be like the one thing that I would consider changing if I had a mulligan, like if I had a redo. So like I said, leading into the digestion issue, did you struggle with any digestion issues or did you notice any change in digestion? So prior to going all in, I didn't really struggle with digestion problems. I ate really high volume foods.
Like this is like a lot of food.
It was kind of normal that like at the end of the day, I'd feel pretty bloated, but nothing like totally out of the ordinary. I felt like that was pretty common. Like when you eat food, sometimes you get bloated and like that's just the way it is, especially when you eat a lot of high volume foods. So I was kind of accepting of that. The main digestion issues that I got were, like I said, in the first month of my all-in journey. I felt like I was still digesting food from the day before in the morning because I would eat mostly whole foods. And it was just like the bloat that I got from the first month was a severe type of bloat. Like it was like next level bloating because I felt pressure and I felt like so uncomfortable. I felt like my digestion efficiency was so horrible because I was also eating like every single hour. So I think that eating maybe like more processed foods would have been easier on my digestion. It was bad. I'd feel uncomfortable a lot in the first month.
If I have to loosen up my fanny pack one more time, throwing this out the window, I'm getting a backpack.
And as soon as I kind of stepped away from the whole foods rule, my digestion got a lot better. Calories were probably still the same because, you know, when you eat more processed foods, you're eating higher calories. So calories didn't change much from like month one to month two and month three, but the volume of food changed a lot, which really, really alleviated me that feeling of like immense pressure in my stomach. And in month three, when my appetite did eventually start to go down, and I also wasn't eating as frequently throughout the day, I was eating like 3 to 4 proper meals. When I got back from that trip from Bali, I started eating more regimented meals, which helped a lot with my digestion. Like having time in between when you eat is better for digestion. And when you eat literally, like when you don't stop eating all day long, like that's when you run into some problems. That's when I noticed things start to get better. And now I don't struggle with any like issues like that anymore. If you're struggling with digestion and maybe you do intermittent fasting or something like that, where you eat a lot of food and like a short window of time, that might be the reason. You might need to give yourself more space in between meals. Okay, so this is a good question. This is a question about my training. How has your mindset and approach towards the gym / lifting changed / evolved / adjusted since all in comparison to pre all in Stephanie? So the evolution of my thought process behind my training has changed a lot since I've gone all in. To start, pre all in Stephanie was so hyper focused on hypertrophy training. So when you get really lean, you lose a lot of muscle. And I felt like I was losing so much of the muscle that I had worked so hard for. So I was like predominantly focused on hypertrophy training. You know, when you get really lean, you lose a lot of strength when you lose a lot of weight. Strength training just wasn't on my priority list because I was really bad at it. So when you lose a lot of strength and you don't feel like you're good at like the compound lifts anymore, you feel really weak and your ego is taking a hit, you're less inclined to do that type of training because you're just bad at it. And I felt pretty dour about the fact that I used to feel and be so strong and I lost that. Like I was just like desperately trying to hold on to any muscle that I had left. Like I would train glutes, like no kidding. Before I went all in, I trained glutes like 5 or 6 times a week. It was like every day. Every day was glute day. Every day was leg day. I really think it did help me preserve the muscle that I had. I did definitely lose some, but I definitely tried my best to preserve as much muscle as I could. When I went all in and I had all this energy from all the food that I was eating, I was like, getting back into strength training. I'm gonna get my deadlift up, I'm gonna get my squat up, I'm gonna be strong. And I was so motivated by the initial food intake that I really wanted to get my strength up. So like, this is what happened in my all-in journey. So at the beginning, it was super high, then it came crashing down in my second month of being all-in because I got super sick. So I went on a trip to Bali and Australia, got hella sick. I could not recover from this terrible cold. I was weak and fatigued and tired, and I was just like basking in the glory of all the food that I was eating. I was eating so much food and I completely rested. So I went from like intense strength training to no training at all for like over a month. And then after not training for like a really long time, the motivation was back up to get back into strength training. And then it went back down because at my heaviest weight, I was oddly uncoordinated. I don't know what happened. I don't know if it's because I gained a lot of weight really fast, but like all my coordination went out the window. It was like my body didn't, I didn't know where to put my extra body. Like I didn't know where to put my stance, and my deadlift was all different. Okay, I can't even squat as deep in the hole anymore because my thighs won't let me. Just felt all sorts of uncoordinated. I don't even know if I've talked about this, but I did. And maybe that was because I gained weight so quickly that I didn't have enough time for like my mental coordination to catch up with how much extra body that I had. There was a period of time when I was at my heaviest weight that I felt very uncomfortable in the gym. Like I felt like this cellulite through my leggings was just like unflattering, and lighting that is meant to give you like this shadowy appearance when you're super shredded does the opposite effect when you're not shredded. It emphasizes every single lump and bump and all of your flaws. I hated all the mirrors, so I took a break from lifting again. So when I took a step back and then I got back into, like, because you know when you take some time off, you're like itching to get back into the gym. So I would itch to get back into it, and I would, and then worldwide pandemic happened and the quarantine happened, and then I had to train at home. And that was really long-winded answer to say that I was really motivated by strength at times and then motivated zero at times. But throughout the entire journey, I can confidently say that I was never really motivated by looking a certain way from my training. Like I had completely taken a step back from training at all for any type of physique or aesthetic purposes, which was so good for me mentally. Like it was like such a mental break that I needed. My newest mindset, I am just focused on being healthy. I want to have like a healthy body composition. I want to get my muscle, like any muscle that I lost over the year of kind of like, I don't know, non-consistent training, I guess you could say. Not for a certain look, but for a certain health standard, like a certain health quota that I would like to hold myself to. But for the past year and a half, it has not been about the way that I look, which is great. Next question. Do you still have any food rules that you have trouble letting go of? And two, what has been your favorite part of your all-in journey so far? So for the first part of the question, do I have any food rules right now? The one thing that I would say that would be loosely interpreted as like a rule is that I'm really trying to eat breakfast, and I'm really trying to space my meals throughout the day just to pick up my appetite a bit. It's not like this hard-nosed rule where I'm like, I'm forcing myself to eat even when I'm like really not hungry. But it's just a habit that I'm trying to enforce within myself to adopt more balanced and more evenly spaced meals throughout the day. I wouldn't really say it's a rule. In terms of like something that I restrict myself from, like I don't eat this or don't eat that, like that type of rule, I don't have that. There's no food that's off limits and I eat whatever I want. I'm definitely not scared of eating. Like Thanksgiving just happened, and I hope you guys, to my American subscribers, I really hope that you guys had a wonderful Thanksgiving. I encouraged everybody on Thanksgiving on my Instagram to make sure that you do not fear food, that you deserve to eat. So if you are one of those people who fear eating, especially on days like today, I just want you to know that you deserve to eat too. You deserve all the happiness and joy that a family meal brings to people, and that having these food rules is just so inhibiting to a happy and like joyful life, because having social meals with loved ones and family is such a good part of life, and I wouldn't want anybody to miss out on that. So I just had Thanksgiving, ate all of the food that I wanted, the mac and cheese, the biscuits. When we had dessert, it was an apple pie cheesecake and it was delicious. I have no rules and I don't like restrict in any type of way. And then the second part of the question is kind of just related to Thanksgiving, in my opinion. What has been your favorite part of your all-in journey so far is the social element of eating feels so much more normalized to me now. Whereas before, I would like eat before I went out to dinner with friends or family, and I would always, you know, to balance my physique aesthetic, I would get like, you know, chicken, broccoli, rice, or a sweet potato or something like that, like I feel like I let all of that go. Like when I go to a restaurant, I just order what I want. Like I look at the menu, I'm like, oh, I really want spaghetti. Like I'm gonna get some spaghetti. Another example would be when Jeff and I order pizza, I'm like, oh, I could totally smash like a medium pizza, like all by myself, right? So I'm like, I'm gonna order that pizza. This is my flavor. If you want some, like, it's like, I'm gonna get a barbecue chicken pizza. If you want some, you're gonna have to trade me a slice of your pizza for one of mine, because I'm gonna want all 8 slices of this pizza.
That's yours. This is mine.
And I don't feel like I need to eat other stuff to fill myself up on that stuff to then eat less of the good stuff. You know what I mean? You feel me. Okay, so this is gonna be my last question, and this one is not going to be at all related to All In. So I'm gonna end off on this note. Given your family commitments, will Jeff move to Florida at some point? Have you and Jeff discussed long-term plans for the relationship? Thank you so much for asking, by the way. I know Jeff has become a big part of my channel. He's actually not here with me now. Jeff is currently in Canada right now. He had to leave to go back because Jeff, if you don't know, Jeff is Canadian. So Jeff can only be in the US only 6 months. For me, it complicates things a little bit because I am one of the primary caretakers to my mom. My sister and I both take turns taking care of her. Because I've mentioned this before, but I'll mention it again if you don't know. My mom is mentally ill. So she's not only mentally ill, her physical health has deteriorated so much in like the last 5 to 7 years or so. There's like kind of like a long and complicated history with that. And she lives in a facility where she does have some help with like daily life, but it's just not enough. Like she needs help. Like we give her showers, we dress her. There's times where I brush her teeth, I feed her. Like it's not just little things. I'm trying really hard to balance taking care of her with having like a normal life too. My sister is helping a lot with that because my sister is a nurse. I say all of that to say that that is the reason why my commitment to my family remains in Florida, and it is not easy for me to be with Jeff right now to travel. Jeff and I have really thought of like long-term solutions to this. And I know like a big question is probably going to be, why don't you guys get married? But Jeff and I really strongly believe in the fact that we do not want to get pressured into getting married because of our living situation. We want to get married because we want to get married. We don't want it to be forced. Right now we're trying our best to accommodate my current situation the best that we can without any, you know, drastic or rash decisions. And I acknowledge how selfish it feels that my family at this moment in time takes precedence, but I just can't let go of not taking care of my mom. Like I'll just never not do that. And Jeff is so understanding of that, and he doesn't mind at all, and he loves my mom too. So it's not an issue. It's just we're trying to work out the logistics to the best of our ability, because Jeff and I have been together now for 4.5 years, something like that. That is gonna be the end. Let me know if you like Q&As. Like I will definitely be able to do, I could do Q&As for the rest of time with how many questions I got submitted, but like the video if you like Q&As, subscribe if you happen to be new, and I will see you in a video very soon. I love you guys so much. Bye. Kept my leg crossed for way too long. Oh my goodness. Okay, goodbye guys.